Hi everyone. So in this session, we'll be discussing about how to create a IBM Jet Series dashboard in Dynatrace. Okay, what are the metrics we need to take at? Okay, so first we'll use this header value. Header value is not required. We'll take a problem first. Okay. So we'll take a problem. Give me a minute. Okay. So we'll take a management zone. So we'll take a, what is the management zone? We'll take a mainframe, okay? So we'll take a mainframe. So this problem you can see only for mainframe applications, okay? Then same, we'll take a host here. So we'll add it here. Right here. What is happening? Oh my god. Okay. So here also we'll take a management zone for mainframe. Okay, so we have two management zones. So we have two servers. Okay. That is done. Let's reduce this only for two servers we have, right? That is enough. Okay. Now we'll take a some other custom metrics, okay. So custom metrics, we'll take a custom chart. We'll put it here. Configure custom charts. We'll search for mainframe. Transaction CPU time. Okay, this is for. We'll take not average, we'll take a count value. Okay. So we'll take a top list. So filter by service. Filter by transaction ID. So that's it. We can update the dashboard tile. Okay, fine. Then we'll take one more. So one more, what I need to do is we'll take another custom charts. We'll put it here. Configure custom chart. Again, we'll type mainframe okay. Failure rate. Okay. Okay, so same, what I need to do is, so we can filter with service and transaction ID. So we'll take a ratio matching. Okay, we'll take a top list value. So this is that. We can update the dashboard tile. Then we'll take we'll take custom charts. We'll put it here. Yeah, you can put it here. Okay, configure custom chart. Now what I need to do, I will take Z slash OS general CPU, right? Okay. So this is called as a CPU utilization. So you can take as a CPU utilization. Okay. Then we are getting that value. If you would like to split by host, that's fine. So we'll take a top list. Take a time series, that's fine. I don't want to split. Sorry, guys. I'm day two, that's what time. Somewhat like this, we can use it. Then done. Then again, we'll take a custom chart. Okay, so we'll take a custom chart. Configure custom chart. We'll take the main frame and CPU time. With transaction ID, with top list, high overall CPU. Okay. So you can take this one, take this value, then what I need to do is, I need to take a database. So then I take a services. So what I need to do is take another value, take another custom chart. Configure custom chart. Then average CPU time. Mainframe CPU time. We'll take average. Transaction ID. Okay, update to dashboard tile. Then edit DB database. Select the database, right? So we need to select the database. So DB, this is the database. then what else? Services. We'll take services. Which service, right? We'll type CICS. Okay. So all key request. Yeah. You can take all key request. Okay. Then what else? Then we'll take another matrix. Edit custom chart configure again mainframe We'll take this one. Okay. Filtered by transaction ID. Okay. Update dashboard tile. Okay. What we can so now we need to do some arrangement. Okay, so for arrangement, what we can do is we can put it to this here. This would be here. This would be here. This would be here. This would be here. So I'm doing somewhat arrangement. And doing some kind of arrangement. Okay. No, it looks good. Okay, so noise looks good. So this is the way to create a IBM Data Series dashboard. So these are the metrics you can use it. That's it, guys. We'll catch you in the next lecture.